Underground river crossings, 13-kilometre tunnels and train stations 45 metres underground are all helping dig the Premier out of a tight spot.
With this rail project, we are talking about the largest single public transport project ever undertaken in Queensland, more than matching our investment in busways.
The opposition says the new inner city rail plan is reactionary politics, reliant on federal government funding.
Every time that there's a problem, they need to pull out a big picture, big ticket item. They've done it again today. We now need to see the rail tracks. We now actually need to see some definable timeframes about when we're going to see an underground in Queensland.
The proposed underground train lines will connect Ipswich and Caboolture and link the Gold Coast with the northern suburbs. The state wants 50-50 funding or better from the federal government's $20 billion Building Australia Fund. After struggling in the polls and losing Labor MP Ronan Lee to the Greens, the Bligh government is fighting to maintain control of the political agenda. The new Green MP says the transport plan is a direct response to the rising importance of environmental issues.
You're seeing that today. The government was forced to respond to my decision to join the Greens by actually, you know, the bar's been lifted. Where was the Premier last week on an underground rail network?
A feasibility study for the proposed project starts next year. With federal funding, the first phase could begin within 4 years. Hannah Wicks, QT News.